Hello, in this video we will look at the next step of the scheduling process of adding team members to your schedule. First up though, is an activity that we added in our previous video that I'd just like to take out to maintain consistency with the textbook schedule, and that's the date constrained project kickoff meeting. So what I've done is just clicked on the three that highlights the whole role. Click on the task tab and click on cut, and that gets rid of it. Okay, to add team members to your activities, we need to look at a new view. So we've been looking at the Gantt chart view. Let's look at the resource sheet view. Now, in this one, we list all of the resources, all of the people that will be possibly working on our project. Now, if you refer to page 81 of your textbook, you'll see early in the planning process, oftentimes we don't know who exactly the people are, but we know the types of resources we need. So, for example, we need a project manager. Now, in this case, because it's the project manager doing this, this is the one that is known often. So in this case, we know that it's going to be Sophie. It's a work resource. We'll talk about that more in another video. There's an initials column, which can be used in some reports. And there's a maximum field. This is the maximum amount this resource is available to the project. So 100% means 8 hours per day. Now, project managers in DecoCam productions are normally work on other things, not just one project at a time. So we're going to set that to be 50. The other resources, business analyst, I'm going to leave at 100%. Graphic designer, also 100%. Specialist, marketing specialist, and here's the last resource. So we've got our six resources. They're all set up there. One is an actual name. The others are more skill names. That's what we know at this point. So let's go to our Gantt chart. And now our challenge is we need to allocate the resources to the appropriate activities. Now, word of advice, please only assign resources to the lowest level activities, the actual work items. Don't, even though the software will allow you, don't assign resources to summary tasks. It will technically work because then their time is prorated to each of the ones below, but it gets really complex. So please don't. So initiate the project. If we look on page 82, we see that the project manager or Sophie is assigned 50% to this task. So to do so, here's how you do it. Click on the resource tab, which makes sense, and click on something called assign resources, which again makes sense. This brings up a dialog box and it lists the six resources. And now it's asking, well, what one or more resources are going to work on this activity? So in this case, it's Sophie for 50% and make the assignment. You can see she ends up here. So all good. Project approval is a milestone. Don't assign resources to milestones. There's no work involved. It doesn't make sense. And the project is a little different because the Sophie is assigned for 50%, but also the business analyst is assigned for 100%. So that's a little trickier. Well, first of all, there's the business analyst, and we will assign 100%. And then Sophie, we will assign, just to press enter there. Sophie, we will assign to be 50%. Okay. You can see she moves up there. So that's how we want it. We'll press assign and that appears. Now we did something wrong there. You know, there's a little example where I accidentally assigned the marketing specialist. So that's okay. That can happen. What we just do is highlight and remove. that's done. Just took me a couple of clicks to get that done. So that's good. Now, this little message came up saying, hey, what's going on? And it's saying, what do you want to do? Do you want to increase the duration? You know, it was originally 7 days, but keep the same duration. So the default is good. So we're all good there. And then you just keep on doing that of assign resources to each. Now, there are, as in often with software packages like this, there's multiple ways of doing things. There is a column called resource names, and our actions here resulted in those names being put in this column. So you can actually just use this column, especially if you are assigning 100%. It works very quickly. So for example, for create sign and graph, assign graphics text, this is the graphic designer. So you can just go like that and press graphic design. Oops, you have to click on the box and then click somewhere else, get graphic designer. You can also just put your cursor into there and press the G, and that will also, it's just the first letter of the name, that'll also do that. Another thing you can do is you can copy and paste. For example, I'm pressing Control C, and then I go to here, press Control V, and it copies it in. We can drag these down. So for example, I can drag the handle down and do that. Now, be careful when you're dragging down. If you happen to drag it across a summary task, then things won't work out the way you like. So take care when you're doing this. And so you continue to do this, and everything's quick and easy to do. Now, here's a little thing that you can run into. For example, let's jump down to create SM strategy. Now, in this case, for this task, the communication specialist is supposed to be assigned to this. But let's say we either make a mistake or we think, hey, let's assign the graphic designer to this. So if we try to do this, watch what happens. So we get this little red person that shows up in both this task and this task. And what it's telling us, that red person means you've over-allocated somebody on those two tasks. And in specifically, it's the graphic designer, because you're essentially saying that person needs to work 8 hours on create sign, graphics text, and work 8 hours on create SM strategy on the same days, actually the Monday and the Tuesday, which it's overtime. It's over allocation beyond their maximum. So you don't want to do that. You want to clear up those red people. And the way we could do this in this case, we could say, oops, that was a mistake. It's not that person, but it's this person. And then see what happens. The allocation, the over allocation goes away, and everything's good. So now at some point in the project, you're going to get to know, well, who the graphic designer is and who the business analyst is. And this may happen all at once or once, maybe a resource at a time. So for example, let's say that it becomes known who the business analyst is. So we can go back to the resource sheet and we'll realize, well, this is Jason has just been assigned to the project. So we'll go in and replace the name. Everything else stays the same. If we go back to the Gantt chart, you can see that Jason was slotted into the right place, but everything else stays the same. Let's have a quick look at the completed product. If we were to have done this across all of the activities, this would be your final product, and you can see that now all the names are in, because by this point in the planning, we know who's working on each activity. They've all been assigned, and so that is done. So that's the end of this video. We'll see you at the next one.